Parshat Re'eh. Behold, I present to you today the blessing and the curse, the good and the evil. This is, in effect, a covenant. The content of that covenant, which is introduced in Parashat Re'eh, just as the Jews are about to enter the land of Israel for the very first time after their wanderings in the desert. We hear about a covenant. Now, this is a new covenant. In addition to the covenant which was given at Sinai, the Torah says this very, very carefully and very, very clearly. After the covenant, and different from the covenant at Sinai, is now this special covenant before the entry into Israel. And this is a covenant whose blessings and curses are not spelled out immediately in Parshat Re'eh, but they are rather spelled out later on in Parshat Ki Tavo, in chapter 27 of the book of Deuteronomy. And something very interesting. The Jews are to place on stones which they got from the River Jordan, which they extracted from the River Jordan. These laws, this covenant, chapter 27, verse 8, and you shall write on the stones all of the words of this Torah, Ba'er Heitev, explained exceedingly well. And all of the Midrashim state, explained exceedingly well in all 70 languages of the world. And then there are two big mountains, Mount Gerizim and Mount Eval. Six tribes will intone the blessings, six tribes the curses. And there are actually 12 specific verses of curse. Arur ha'ish, cursed be the person. And all of these laws, different from the laws at Sinai, are laws between human beings. Laws about stealing, laws about harming others physically, laws about giving false advice and placing a stumbling block before the blind. Laws that are really between human beings. And it's now before Israel that they get this third covenant. Now, who is meant for this third covenant? In different words, but the ideas are the same. Israel received at Sinai these laws between human beings. And the noun in these curses are not the Jewish people, but rather the person, the ish, the human being. And therefore, I'd like to make a very important point, which is probably the most important point I can ever make to you. The Jews, before they received the first revelation at Sinai, were called by God a holy nation and a kingdom of priest teachers. That was in Exodus chapter 19. And the Sephorno says about priest teachers, Israel has the task of teaching the entire world, all of humanity, fundamental ethics and morality, the goal of a world of peace with compassionate righteousness and moral justice. When God chose Abraham, he told us immediately that this is our task. Through us, all of the world must become blessed. Now, at the point of entry and exit, entry into and exit from the land of Israel, the newly acquired land of a freed people, they're to put in all languages for the Gentiles the fundamental laws of morality. The third covenant is what we must teach the world. It was Bilam, a Gentile prophet, who called the Jewish people or said about the Jewish people that we are a nation that lives alone. Not to take account of what the nations think of us. Am levadad yishkon. This is not what the Torah told us. This is not what God commands us. We must engage the world and teach the world because God cares and loves all of humanity, not just the Jews. And we must be the priest teachers. Here, in Parshat Re'eh, and described in greater detail in Kitavo, in Deuteronomy chapter 27. The first covenant between the pieces was with Abraham, the national covenant. The second covenant was at Sinai. The third covenant, at the entry and exit point to Israel, in languages of all of humanity, our mandate to teach the world. That's what redemption means. The world will accept our teaching. That is what we are waiting for, and that is our purpose for being. We have seen the realization of God's promise to us that we'll return to Israel and to our nation statehood. May it be very soon that we are able to really teach the world in depth and realize the true period of redemption when the entire world will live in peace and in security. Shabbat Shalom.